Good morning, students. For this session, we are going to discuss the choose the best answer in lesson 5. Unit 5, alkali and alkaline earth metal. According to the deleted portions, have completed this. 5th unit 5 is over. Okay, so now I am going to discuss the choose the best. See the first question. For alkali metal, which of the following is incorrect? Once again, I read the question. For alkali metal, which of the following is incorrect? Children, here the question is given incorrect. This is a negative type of question. Okay, so answer it is very carefully. Here, 4 options is given. First one, hydration energy. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Ionization energy, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Density, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Atomic size. Okay, so now we are going to see the reason one by one. First, hydration energy. You know the definition of hydration energy. Hydration energy is released. Okay, when the energy is released, it is surrounded with water molecules. The alkali metal ion, it is surrounded with water molecules. Okay, so now hydration energy from top to bottom. Okay, that is lithium to rubidium. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. Okay, you know the alkali metal order. In hydration energy, which one is that is greater? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. Okay, so highest hydration energy is lithium. Down the group, the hydration energy decreases. You know very well about the hydration energy concept. Okay, based on the hydration energy, discuss the solubility concept also. So hydration energy is more, the solubility also it is more. Okay, so here the order is given, the order is correct. Okay, so next one, take the option ionization energy. Ionization energy means, what is meant by ionization energy? Energy is required to remove the electron from the outermost shell. Okay, now to form the cation. So here, which one is required high ionization energy? Lithium is required high ionization energy because it's closer to the nucleus and small size. Okay, so here also the order is given, the order is correct. Lithium is more ionization energy than sodium, potassium, rubidium. Okay, so next one, see the atomic size. Okay, based on the atomic number, discuss the atomic size. Now lithium atomic number 3, sodium 11, potassium 19. So the atomic number increases. So whenever the atomic number increases, the size also increases. You know very well. Okay, so this also correct. Now take the density. Here lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, these two also exception. Okay, you know the. Okay, so now lithium density 0.54, sodium density 0.91, potassium density 0.86, rubidium density 1.53. okay, so what is the correct order? First write lithium. Okay, next potassium. Next one, sodium. Next, rubidium. This is the order. But here, they are given the order lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. Okay, rubidium is highest one. So here, the order is not correctly written here. Okay, so the correct option is C. Okay, density. The remaining everything is correct option is C. So the remaining everything is given the correct order. Okay, so now see the second question. Which of the following statement is incorrect? Okay, this also negative type of question, incorrect. Okay, see the option one by one. Lithium plus has minimum hydration among alkali metal cations. Oxidation state, potassium in KO2 is plus 1. Sodium is used to make sodium lead alloy. MgSO4 is readily soluble in water. Okay, now take the option D. Magnesium sulfate is readily soluble in water. Okay, so magnesium in this one, alkaline earth metal. Okay, alkaline earth metal, what is the order? Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. Okay, so now the solubility, beryllium compound, magnesium compound, solubility is quickly soluble. Okay, now because the hydration energy decreases down the group, so this one solubility, readily soluble in water. Next, sodium is used as an alloy. Already studied in the uses. Okay. So next one, oxidation state of potassium in KO2 is plus 1. So now potassium, what is the oxidation state? Potassium, it is present in the alkali metal group. Okay. What is the alkali metal? Lithium, sodium, potassium. Okay, so what about the oxidation state of lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium? This is a plus 1 oxidation state. Okay, otherwise, if we are find out the oxidation state in KO2 compound, okay, so first find out this in which type of oxide. Okay, because here normally potassium oxide, potassium valency 1, oxygen valency 2, so K2O, but here KO2 is given. So now want to analyze this one, which type of oxide, whether it is a superoxide or peroxide. Okay, so this KO2 is a superoxide. Okay, so superoxide means what is the oxygen valency? Minus half. Okay, so now to find out the oxidation state of potassium. So this potassium taken as X. Okay, so between the symbol write the plus. One oxygen minus half. Okay, two oxygen. So 2 into minus half, that minus 1. Okay, here it is a neutral molecule, so it is equal to 0. Okay, so X is equal to here minus 1, so it move opposite side, plus 1. So what about the oxidation state of potassium in KO2? Plus 1 oxidation state. So this statement also it is correct. Now take the first statement, lithium minimum hydration among alkali metal cations. Okay, children, to underline the word minimum. Okay, so it is present in the first element. Okay, so now the lithium atomic size also, it is very small size. This one, more hydration energy than the remaining. So this option is not correct. It is an incorrect statement. So what is the correct, that is answer for 11th question? Option A. Okay, so now see the third question. Which of the following compounds, third question, question number 3. Which of the following compounds will not evolve H2 gas on reaction with alkali metals? Okay, once again I read the question. Which of the following compounds will not evolve hydrogen gas on reaction with alkali metals? Okay, you take any one alkali metals. Okay, so now ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid, what is the formula? Ethanoic acid formula, acid formula COH. Okay, COOH, ethanoic acid, so carbon atom 2. So CH3, COOH. Okay, ethanoic acid. It react with hydrogen gas on reaction with alkali metal. Will not evolve hydrogen gas. So now it react with the sodium. What is the product? To use CH3COONa plus H2, hydrogen gas evolved. But what is the question? Which of the following will not evolve H2 gas? So this one is wrong. Next, take the second option, ethanol. ethanol, what is the formula? C2H5OH. It react with alkali metal. Alkali metal example, lithium, sodium, whatever. Now I am taking sodium metal to use. What is the product? C2H5ONa plus H2. Again, it evolved the hydrogen gas. Okay, so option C, phenol. What is the molecular formula for phenol? C6H5OH. Phenol. It react with metal Na to gives. What is the product? C6H5ONa. Okay, plus H2. Hydrogen gas evolved. But what is the question? Will not evolve H2 gas on reaction with alkali metal. Okay, so here, so now ethanoic acid, it evolve H2. Ethanol also it evolve H2. Phenol also it evolve H2. So among this, anyone it not evolve the H2 gas. So what is the correct option? None of this. இதில் எதுமே என்ன செய்து? Correct கடையாது. Okay, so now see the fourth question. Sodium is stored in. நம்ம சோடியம் மெட்டல் நம்ம எதில் ஸ்டோர் பண்ணி வைக்கணும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி கொஸ்டின் கேட்டிருக்காங்க. ஆல்கஹால்லையா, வாட்டர்லையா, கரசின் ஆர் நன் ஆஃப் திஸ் அப்படிங்கிற கொஸ்டின். இப்போ சோடியம் அப்படிங்கிறது ஒரு ஹைலி ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல் இன் த அட்மாஸ்பியர். இப்போ நம்ம நார்மலாக எடுத்து வெளியில் வச்சோம் அப்படின்னா நம்ம எதுவுமே பண்ண வேண்டாம். இட் ரியாக்ட் வித் மாய்ஸ்டர். ஸோ மாய்ஸ்டர் என்னது? வாட்டர் மாலிகுல் அப்படிதானே. அப்போ சோடியம் இட் ரியாக்ட் வித் வாட்டர் டு கிவ் சோடியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைட் NaOH-ஆக கிடச்சிரும் நம்மளுக்கு, சரிங்களா? அப்போ இதுலேருந்து நமக்கு என்ன தெரிஞ்சு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, இட் இஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி எக்ஸோதோமிக் ரியாக்ஷன். எக்ஸோதோமிக்னானது இட் ரிலீஸ் ஹை ஹீட், சரிதானே? ஸோ ஹை ஹீட்டை ரிலீஸ் பண்ணும். ஸோ இப்போ நம்ம வெளியில் எடுத்து வச்சோம் அப்படின்னா இவ்வளே லைக் நவ் இஃப் இட் கெட் எனி மாய்ஸ்டர் ஈஸிலி இட் பேர்ன்ட், சரிங்களா? இட் அட் த சேம் டைம் இட் இஸ் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோசிவ். ஓகே, ஸோ எக்ஸ்ப்ளோசிவ்னா இது லைட்டாக கொஞ்சம் வெடிச்சத்தோடு கொஞ்சம் இது நல்லா எரியக்கூடிய ஒன்று. ஸோ அதனால எதில் தான் நம்ம வச்சுருக்கோம் நம்மளுக்கு வந்து? இட் கெப்ட் இன் கரசின், சரிங்களா? அப்போ ஆல்கஹால்லையும் வேண்டாம், வாட்டர்லேயும் வைக்க மாட்டோம். நம்ம எதில் வச்சுருப்போம் நம்மளுக்கு வந்து? கரசின் உள்ள தான் நம்ம என்னது டிப் பண்ணி வச்சுருக்கணும். அப்போ இதுக்கு என்ன ரீசன், ஏன் நம்ம கரசினில் வச்சுருக்குறோம் அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா, வெளியில் வச்சோம் அப்படின்னா என்னது? இட் ரியாக்டிவ் மெட்டல். ஸோ இட் கான்டாக்ட் வித் ஆக்சிஜன் கூட, மாய்ஸ்டர் கூட அப்படி சேர்ந்து நமக்கு எதாக கன்வெர்ட் ஆயிரும்? சோடியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைடாக கன்வெர்ட் ஆயிரும். ஸோ அதனால் இட் இஸ் கெப்ட் இன் கரசின். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த கரெக்ட் ஆப்ஷன் இன் ஃபோர்த் ஒன்? Option C, kerosene. Okay. Which of the following? Next question. Which of the following has the highest tendency to give the reaction? M, metal. Okay. Plus ion, gaseous state in aqueous medium to use M plus aqueous solution. So here four option is given. Once again, I read the question. Which of the following has the highest tendency to give the reaction? Okay. So here everything is the alkali metal. Okay. Lithium, sodium, potassium, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium. This is an alkali metal. So among this, which one has the highest tendency? So highest tendency here, water molecule, aqueous medium in the presence of water. Okay, so it is aqueous means we consider as it is a hydration energy. Okay, so among this, which one is the high hydration energy? Lithium has the high hydration energy. So this hydration is based on the size. Okay, so among this, lithium is the smallest size. Next is sodium. Okay, so rubidium is the biggest size. Okay, so now write in the order: lithium, sodium, potassium and rubidium. Rubidium. Okay, so the size, the smallest size is lithium. So it has more hydration energy. So more hydration energy means easily it is soluble in water. That solubility product is more. Okay. So among this, which one is the correct one? Option B, lithium. Okay. So next question. Rubidium, okay, next question. RbO2, rubidium oxide is, that's all. This is a question. Rubidium oxide, RbO2 is, here four options is given. Superoxide, paramagnetic, peroxide, diamagnetic, superoxide, diamagnetic, peroxide, diamagnetic. First, we know the concept. If superoxide means, what is the oxygen valency? Superoxide, oxygen valency. Okay, superoxide, oxygen valency is -1/2. Okay, peroxide, what is the oxygen valency? Peroxide, oxygen valency is -1. Okay, so now first to find out the oxygen oxidation state. Okay, so now see here for example, now to find out the oxygen. Now rubidium, so rubidium is the alkali metal. So now RbO2. Okay, so now RbO2, what is the oxidation state? 1 plus, okay, 2 oxygen X equal to 0. Okay, so now X, 2X, so 2X equal to plus 1, here minus 1. So X equal to, here multiplication, so opposite side division. So -1/2. So -1/2 means, now to find out whether it is superoxide or peroxide. Okay, so now this rubidium oxide is a superoxide. Okay, so next one, whether it is a paramagnetic or diamagnetic, we are going to find out. First, we must know the meaning of what is the paramagnetic, what is diamagnetic. Okay, so diamagnetic means no magnetic properties. Paramagnetic means it contains the magnetic properties. Okay, but now we cannot see manually. Okay, but another one option, now it contains the unpaired electron. If the molecules contain unpaired electron, now it is a paramagnetic. If it all the electrons are paired up, now it is a diamagnetic in nature. Okay, so now to find out whether it is a paramagnetic or diamagnetic. Okay, now here rubidium oxide is split into Rb, okay, plus oxygen, Rb positive charge, oxygen negative, here 2 minus. Okay, so now to find out the number, okay, atomic number. Oxygen atomic number 8, here 2 times 2 oxygen atoms, so 8 plus 8, 16, here minus 1, so gain of 1 electron, so totally 17 electrons. Okay, so in 17 electron, according to MOT theory, molecular orbital theory, we can find whether it is a paramagnetic or diamagnetic. So now to apply the formula, sigma 1s2, okay, sigma 1s*2, sigma 2s2, sigma 2s*2, okay, next sigma 2pz, this is a formula, children. Okay, sigma 2pz. Next, pi 2px, 2 electron. Pi 2py, 2 electron. Next, sigma *2pz, 2 electron. Now, I wanted to calculate all the electron. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 6. 16, okay, remaining 1 electron. So pi 2p x 1 star. Okay, so here only 1 unpaired electron it is present. So it is a paramagnetic in nature. Okay, maybe if it is 16 electron, mean it is a diamagnetic in nature. Okay, children, so this is the way to find out. Okay, so according to this, whether it is a superoxide or peroxide, we come to the conclusion as superoxide. Next one, it is it contain one unpaired electron, so it is a paramagnetic in nature. Okay, so correct option is A. Okay, super oxide as well as it is a paramagnetic in nature. Okay, so now see the seventh question. Next question, find the wrong statement. Find the wrong statement. Sodium metal is used in qualitative organic analysis. Option B, sodium carbonate is soluble in water and it is used in inorganic qualitative analysis. Option C, K2CO3, potassium carbonate can be prepared by Solvay process. Option D, potassium bicarbonate is acidic salt. Okay, four option is given. What is the question? Find the wrong statement. Okay, so now see one by one. Sodium metal is used in organic qualitative analysis. Children, this in the organic chemistry we studied very elaborately sodium extract test. Sodium extract test or Lassine test. Okay, the test ku peru sodium extract test alladhu Lassine test. Using the sodium extract test to identify the nitrogen, sulfur, okay, present in organic compound. So adhan idhula koduthirukanga, sodium metal is used in organic qualitative analysis. Okay, so the statement is correct. Next statement, sodium carbonate. What is the formula for sodium carbonate? Na2CO3, sodium carbonate. Okay, it is soluble in water because it has high hydration energy. Okay, and it is used in inorganic qualitative analysis. So this also, the sodium carbonate is used in the inorganic qualitative analysis. So this statement is correct. Next, option C, potassium carbonate K2CO3 can be prepared by Solvay process. Children, we studied the theory part. Solvay process, we studied the preparation of sodium carbonate. Okay, not potassium carbonate. Okay, so anyway, see the last option also. Potassium bicarbonate is acidic salt. First, potassium bicarbonate is a salt. Okay, so here even the word is acidic salt. K plus H2CO3 minus, even it is slightly that is a basic also. Okay, because it is not possible to remove H+, so it has basic. At the same time, it is the salt also. So potassium bicarbonate is the acidic salt here. So among this, which one is the correct one? Option C is the correct one. Option C. Why? Solvay process prepare the sodium carbonate, not potassium carbonate. Okay, so now we see the next question. Lithium shows diagonal relationship with sodium, option A, magnesium, calcium, aluminium. First we must know the meaning of diagonal relationship. Okay, so diagonal, what is my diagonal? One period, one group difference irukkunu. Adha nam diagonal relationship nam theory padikkum bodhu paathirukkom. For example, take the lithium, okay, lithium, sodium, potassium. Ipo group paakkum bodhu indha maari irukku. Period paathinga appadina lithium, beryllium. Okay, so after beryllium, magnesium. Ipo oru period difference irukku, oru group difference irukku. Ipo period pathinga appadina after the lithium, the present the element is beryllium. Ipo group paathom appadina after the lithium enna element irukku? Sodium. Ipo idhukku adutha varakudi element yaar? Nammalku indha diagonal irukkudi element yaar? Magnesium. Okay, so what is the correct option? Magnesium. Appo lithium shows diagonal relationship with them. Magnesium. So correct option B. See the next question. in which process fused NaOH is electrolyzed for extraction of sodium. Okay. Now, for this question, to prepare the sodium from sodium hydroxide. So, here given the process. So, in which process sodium is extracted from sodium hydroxide? So, we know here give the three options: Kastner process, cyanide process and Down process. So, now we must know each process, what is the function. Okay. So, first Kastner process means extraction of sodium. Okay. Sodium is extracted from sodium hydroxide, NaOH, Kastner process. Cyanide process, in the cyanide process, silver or gold, it is extracted. Okay. So, this generally called as MacArthur Forest cyanide process. Okay. Then the process name in Patina, MacArthur Forest cyanide process. But in the process, we have silver as well as gold. So, this is the board. Silver and gold extract. So, that is the cyanide process. But Down process, extraction of sodium from sodium chloride. So, once again, see the question. In which process fused NaOH is electrolyzed for extraction of sodium? So, what is the correct option? Kastner process. So, padikkum bolude enna process la enna extract pandrom abdingiradha nam enna chinna nyabochikkanum. Cyanide process la enna pandrom? Silver, gold extract pandrom. Down process la enna sodium extract pandrom, but it is extracted from sodium chloride. Children, remaining choose the best answer. We see the next class. Okay, thank you.